So, this morning, Eurogamer got the chance to exclusively reveal details on the hardware for Microsoft's upcoming 8.5 generation system, Xbox One Scorpio. And it's kind of amazing. So, real quick to give a little background on this, what's really interesting about the development of the Scorpio is how it kind of worked in reverse compared to past systems. Normally, when you're making a new gaming system, you just make some powerful hardware, and games will be made based on that. Usually why you'll see games get better and better over time, because they learn to make better use of the resources. Scorpio worked in reverse, though, in that we already have the Xbox One out, we already have a number of games out, so the goal was to take those games and make sure to test a system that will actually run all of them at native 4K and even at 60 frames per second doing so. So, what does it take for the Xbox One Scorpio to achieve 4K console gaming? Well, it has a custom 8-core processor running at 2.3 GHz, that's 30% faster than the original Xbox One, and a GPU consisting of 40 units running at 1,172 MHz. That's 4.6 times more powerful than the original Xbox One and 1.5 times more powerful than the PS4 Pro, meaning that original stated goal of achieving 6 teraflops has happened. It also has 12 gigabytes of RAM with 326 gigabytes per second bandwidth, which is way faster than the PS4 Pro. And once again, this is divided between the UI and actual gameplay, whereas before it was a 5-3 split, it's now 8 gigabytes dedicated to gaming and 4 gigabytes for the UI, so it can also run at a native 4K. Now, it's worth noting that while most game systems do, of course, have some custom parts, the Scorpio has been customized throughout entirely for the purpose of having maximum efficiency in both energy consumption and cooling, including a new vapor cooling technology. Now, along with this, we've also confirmed that the system will have a 1 TB hard drive, it will have an internal power supply like the Xbox One S, so no more giant brick on the cable anymore, and it's going to have the same back ports as the Xbox One S, including a power port, HDMI in, HDMI out, a pair of USB ports, optical, Ethernet, and an IR port. So, there's a bunch of fancy numbers, but what does it actually all mean in practice? Well, as a proof of concept, Xbox showed a stress test demo of Forza 6 using the same graphics it has on Xbox One, but running at 4K. And according to Eurogamer, it ran at a perfectly smooth 60 frames per second. Now, of course, Forza 6 is a very well-optimized game, and it is a first-party game from Microsoft, so that means that while it does work there, it doesn't necessarily hold true for third-party titles. But it does prove that 4K gaming on a console is possible. Another really cool thing that was noted too is that the Scorpio is designed to output in whatever resolution you want, regardless of the monitor you're using. So if you're using a 1080p display, you can still render out at 4K and have it super sampled to the screen, resulting in a crisper image, something that PS4 Pro had the option to do, but didn't. Now, speaking of the PS4 Pro, the Scorpio is definitely more powerful for those of you wondering, though they do have very different philosophies of how to approach 4K gaming. The Pro was a sort of affordable option that went for native 4K gaming in a small handful of titles, but for the most part relied on techniques like checkerboard upscaling to make it look as close as possible while saving some performance. The Scorpio, on the other hand, is this highly custom, souped-up machine that's going for brute force actual native 4K gaming. And something like that, while awesome, isn't gonna come cheap. We still don't have a for sure release date just yet or a for sure price point, but from the way things look, we're gonna find the release date at E3 with a price point probably around $500, maybe as low as $450 if they're gonna be really, really aggressive with it.